سلام، وقتتون بخیر. فرام عزیزی هستم، مدرس زبان، در خدمتتون هستم با آموزش جامع ترین دوره افعال عبارتی. بریم به بررسی درس امروز بپردازیم. فقط قبل از شروع درس، اگر از این ویدیو خوشتون اومد و براتون مفید بود، ممنون میشم که کانال رو سابسکرایب کنید و ویدیو رو هم لایک کنید. سوالات و نظرات خودتون رو هم در قسمت کامنت بنویسید.
در خدمتتون هستم با تدریس جامع ترین دوره افعال عبارتی. من احساس کردم که چیزی که توی حوزه آموزش زبان نیاز بیشتر روش کار کنیم همین مبحث افعال عبارتی هست. به نظر من این حیطه افعال عبارتی باید کار بیشتری روش انجام بشه. به همین دلیل تصمیم گرفتم که یک دوره آموزشی تهیه کنم که شما بتونید به بهترین نحو این افعال عبارتی رو یاد بگیرید. من سعی کردم که مثال‌های خیلی زیادی براتون آماده کنم. بعضی از این مثال‌هایی که براتون آماده کردم از فیلم و سریال هست که این خیلی میتونه کمکتون کنه که اون فریزال ورب، اون فعل عبارتی رو بهتر درک کنید، بهتر اونو متوجه بشید و بتونید از اون در مکالمات روزمره‌تون استفاده کنید. حالا چون جلسه اول این دوره هست، من اول توضیح بدم راجع به افعال عبارتی. افعال عبارتی به انگلیسی میشه phrasal verbs. phrasal verbs. ببینید، یه فعل رو در نظر بگیرید. اگه ما بیایم بعد از یه فعلی یه حرف اضافه یا قید بیاریم، به این ترکیب میگیم فعل عبارتی یا phrasal verb. بعضی هم بهش میگن افعال چند قسمتی. حالا به این حرف اضافه و یا قیدی که بعد از فعل میاد به اون میگیم پارتیکل. دیگه از الان به اون حرف اضافه و قیدی که بعد از فعل میاد به اون میگیم چی؟ پارتیکل. اینا رایج‌ترین پارتیکلایی هستن که در افعال عبارتی استفاده میشن. حالا یه مثال بگم که اینو کامل متوجه بشید. نگاه کنید، پوت یعنی گذاشتن. من بیام بعدش آن بیارم، آن چیه؟ آن یه حرف اضافه است. حالا این ترکیبو من بهش میگم چی؟ phrasal verb. پوت فعل، یه فعل معمولیه، ولی پوتان چیه؟ پوتان phrasal verb، یه فعل عبارتیه. معنیشم کلا عوض شده. پوت یعنی گذاشتن، پران یعنی پوشیدن. پور اوت یعنی خاموش کردن. این پور اوت یک phrasal verb. پراب یعنی ساختن یا بالا بردن. یا مثلا ترن یعنی چرخیدن، یه فعل معمولیه، ولی ترن آن چیه؟ یه فعل عبارتیه، یعنی روشن کردن. ترن آن phrasal verb. یا ترن آف phrasal verb، معنیش یعنی خاموش کردن. turn up یعنی زیاد کردن، turn down یعنی کم کردن. اینا همشون چی هم؟ phrasal verb هستن. خب این از مفهوم افعال عبارتی. حالا بریم سراغ مطالبی که میخوام تو این جلسه بهتون آموزش بدم. تو این جلسه میخوایم راجع به 4 تا فعل عبارتی صحبت کنیم: come apart, come about, come around, come across. بریم سراغ اولی، come apart. ببینید come یعنی آمدن، come apart یعنی چی؟ come apart یعنی از هم جدا شدن، تکه تکه شدن، فرو پاشیدن، متلاشی شدن، پاره شدن. این معنی ها رو داره. To break into pieces. حالا برای اینکه این فعل عبارتی رو بهتر متوجه بشی، 3 تا مثال تو این صفحه براتون آماده کردم. بعدش میریم سراغ مثال هایی که از فیلم و سریال براتون آماده کردم. I picked up the cake. من کیک رو بلند کردم. And it came apart in my hands. و تو دستام چی شد؟ کیک از هم جدا شد، تیکه تیکه شد. بعدی، I picked up the magazine and it came apart in my hands. I picked up the magazine. من مجله رو بلند کردم. And it came apart in my hands. و تو دستام چی شد؟ تکه تکه شد، پاره شد. A marriage can come apart for many reasons. میگه یه ازدواج میتونه متلاشی بشه، فرو بپاشه به خاطر دلایل زیادی. اینجا come apart معنیش یعنی فرو پاشیدن. خب حالا بریم سراغ مثال هایی که از فیلم و سریال براتون آماده کردم.
Let's get back to the topic. I want to talk to you about stability in the ring. I've shown you the ring can come apart. Let's get back to the topic. I want to talk to you about stability in the ring. I've shown you the ring can come apart. Let's get back to the topic. I want to talk to you about stability in the ring. I've shown you the ring can come apart.
We need to close the cake together like this. And that's going to come apart. We need to close the cake together like this. And that's going to come apart. We need to close the cake together like this. And that's going to come apart.
This does come apart, which is always nice. So you can replace this if you need to. This does come apart, which is always nice, so you can replace this if you need to. This does come apart, which is always nice, so you can replace this if you need to.
So the toilet paper does not come apart in the liquid nitrogen. So the toilet paper does not come apart in the liquid nitrogen. So the toilet paper does not come apart in the liquid nitrogen.
So I mentioned that when an egg boils or gets hot, the proteins unravel and come apart. So I mentioned that when an egg boils or gets hot, the proteins unravel and come apart. So I mentioned that when an egg boils or gets hot, the proteins unravel and come apart.
Oh, all right. It's just come apart.
So watch out! It can cause your marriage to completely come apart. So watch out! It can cause your marriage to completely come apart. So watch out! It can cause your marriage to completely come apart.
But how many times do you hear a man come apart like that? But how many times do you hear a man come apart like that? But how many times do you hear a man come apart like that?
How can a country come apart like this? How can a country come apart like this? How can a country come apart like this?
خب این سراغ فریزالور بعدی که خیلی آسونه. Come about. پیشیدگی خاصی نداره. معنیش یعنی اتفاق افتادن. To happen. مثلا How did the accident come about? چطور تصادف اتفاق افتاد رخ داد؟ Why did that come about? چرا اون اتفاق افتاد؟ حالا به این سراغ مثال هایی که از فیلم و سریال براتون آماده کردم.
How did all this come about? How did all this come about? How did all this come about?
Rose, this sort of thing can come about, you know. Rose, this sort of thing can come about, you know. Rose, this sort of thing can come about, you know.
How did it come about that you worked for the Jansons? How did it come about that you worked for the Jansons? How did it come about that you worked for the Jansons?
When did this come about? When did this come about? When did this come about?
How'd that come about, Dexter? How'd that come about, Dexter? How'd that come about, Dexter?
خب به این سراغ سومین فعل عبارتی که براتون آماده کردم. Come around. یکی از معنی های come around اینه به هوش اومدن. دوتا معنی از come around براتون آماده کردم. یکی از معنی های come around اینه به هوش اومدن. To become conscious again. مثلا When she came around, وقتی به هوش اومد, we were sitting by her bed. کنار تختش نشسته بودیم. ما کنار تختش نشسته بودیم. The little girl became happy when her father came around. میگه اون دختر کوچیکه خوشحال شد وقتی که پدرش به هوش اومد. It took him 2 days to come around. 2 روز طول کشید که به هوش بیاد. حالا معنی دومه. Come around اینه. یعنی اومدن، سر زدن. این معنی ها رو داره. To come to a place. اومدن به یه مکان. Especially به خصوص someone's house. خونه یه نفر. اومدن به خونه یه نفر واسه چی؟ To visit for a short time. I'll come around later. میگه من بعدن میام. بعدن سر میزنم. Please come around and see us. لطفاً بیا و ما رو ببین. بیا به ما سر بزن و ما رو ببین. خب حالا بریم سراغ مثال هایی که براتون آماده کردم.
You come around in a minute. Come on. You come around in a minute. Come on. You come around in a minute. Come on.
Cop came around last night looking for you again. Cop came around last night looking for you again. Cop came around last night looking for you again.
Nobody came around here looking for the facts. Nobody came around here looking for the facts. Nobody came around here looking for the facts.
Your husband came around again asking to see the kids. Your husband came around again asking to see the kids. Your husband came around again asking to see the kids.
Girl came around looking for you. Girl came around looking for you. Girl came around looking for you.
He's fine, actually. He just came around about 10 minutes ago. He's fine, actually. He just came around about 10 minutes ago. He's fine, actually. He just came around about 10 minutes ago.
I just want to tell you, those detectives came around. I just want to tell you, those detectives came around. I just want to tell you, those detectives came around.
When I came around, he was gone. When I came around, he was gone. When I came around, he was gone.
I'm so glad you finally came around. I'm so glad you finally came around. I'm so glad you finally came around.
I'm very happy you came around. I'm very happy you came around. I'm very happy you came around.
آخرین فعل عبارتی که تو این فیلم می‌خوایم بررسی کنیم اینه come across. Come across فریزال ورب مهمیه. زیاد ازش استفاده میکنن، شما هم یاد بگیرید اینو و سعی کنید که این فریزال ورب رو در مکالمات روزمره خودتون استفاده کنید. معادلای فارسی که میتونیم برای فعل کام اکراس بگیم اینا هستن: مواجه شدن با، روبرو شدن با، برخورد کردن با، اتفاقی پیدا کردن، اتفاقی ملاقات کردن. اینا معادلای فارسیشن. حالا الان تو مثالهایی که توی فیلم و سریال براتون آماده کردم مشخص کردم که هر مثالی چه معنی داره. To meet, find, or discover someone or something by chance. The detective came across someone who knew who killed that man. میگه کاراگاه با شخصی برخورد کرد، اتفاقی با شخصی ملاقات کرد که میدونست چه کسی اون مرد رو کشت. The police came across some documents which proved he was innocent. پلیس اتفاقی تعدادی سند و مدرک پیدا کرد که ثابت کرد او بیگناه بود.
Because whatever we do, we are going to come across obstacles along the way. Because whatever we do, we are going to come across obstacles along the way. Because whatever we do, we are going to come across obstacles along the way.
In my research, I've come across five particular things that I think every organization can and should do. In my research, I've come across five particular things that I think every organization can and should do. In my research, I've come across five particular things that I think every organization can and should do.
You know, I would come across things that no kid should come across. You know, I would come across things that no kid should come across. You know, I would come across things that no kid should come across.
In my work, I come across vulnerable experiences often. In my work, I come across vulnerable experiences often. In my work, I come across vulnerable experiences often.
Have you come across this idea? Have you come across this idea? Have you come across this idea?
We're dealing with a very effective weapon system that we have not come across before. We're dealing with a very effective weapon system that we have not come across before. We're dealing with a very effective weapon system that we have not come across before.
It's nothing new, actually. We've come across this situation before. It's nothing new, actually. We've come across this situation before. It's nothing new, actually. We've come across this situation before.
I came across what appeared to be a kidnapping in process. I came across what appeared to be a kidnapping in process. I came across what appeared to be a kidnapping in process.
It's one of the names I came across in the suspect's notebook. It's one of the names I came across in the suspect's notebook. It's one of the names I came across in the suspect's notebook.
We know that you spoke with officers yesterday, but could you tell us again how you came across the book? We know that you spoke with officers yesterday, but could you tell us again how you came across the book? We know that you spoke with officers yesterday, but could you tell us again how you came across the book?